Does India hate its Muslims so much that they celebrate those who target and kill Muslims? I mean, it's one thing to totally ignore or even tolerate Muslim lynchings, but to blatantly come together in thousands and openly support and celebrate these murderers is actually taking the next step to genocide. And this is exactly what is happening in India right now. After the brutal mob lynching of 25-year-old Asif Khan in Haryana on May 16th, a Mahapanchayat was organized in Nuh on May 30th, where around 50,000 people gathered. Despite the surging COVID cases, despite an imposed Section 144, to express and give their support to the ones who murdered Asif. And this is just one of the many such Mahapanchayats that occurred in many villages in Haryana. The recipe for these gatherings were pretty much the same. First, praise the murderers for acting out in the name of Hindutva. Add Muslim hate to speeches to justify their killings. Mix it up with dehumanizing them as well to add a little bit of flavor. Put it all on a plate that scares people into thinking India will become Pakistan. Then serve it to the public mass in order to inspire them to pick up arms and kill more and more Muslims. We have to become Ram, pick up your weapons and kill the anti-nationals, declared Om Singh Chauhan, the president of Bharatiya Kisan Sangh, an organization that is affiliated to the RSS, by the way.
भाई जरा सच्चा और अच्छा हिंदू अपना हाथ खड़ा कर ले पहलवान साहब हिंदुओं पर दशक मत करो अगर कोई एक आज पाकिस्तान की औलाद बैठा हो तो वो भी अपना हाथ खड़ा कर दे भाई
Now the same people on the internet who are seeing such open and violent celebration of hate and killing are shocked and frightened. What is happening in India? Where is all this leading to? Why is no one talking about it? Well, hello, I have news for you. More shocking news. This is not the first time that this is a phenomenon. Remember Shambhulal Rikar from Rajasthan? Yeah, the same man who burned and hacked a Muslim migrant worker on camera in 2017. He is celebrated to such an extent that he was not only offered to contest elections in Agra in 2019, but is also included as a historic figure in processions. And even songs are being composed in his honor. For example, in a Ram Navami procession in Jodhpur, a man dressed up like Shambhulal, complete costume with even the pickaxe he used to chop his victims, and he was carried around on a tableau sitting on a throne, hailed as the man who curbed love jihad. Some Hindu political organizations even promised to take care of his every need, pay for his children's education, give free ration to his family. And why? Because he was able to awaken the sleeping Hindutva in all of us, as claimed by the extremist organization Bajrang Dal. And people like Shambhulal is inspiring many to follow in his footsteps. And why not? Because this comes with a lot of fame and benefits. Why, even in the Mahapanchayat we were talking about, the man who killed 17-year-old Junaid was there to extend his celebrity endorsement to the ones who killed Asif Khan. Now, this is so messed up, but it's becoming very normal. This mentality of celebrating and honoring the killers is also endorsed by those in power as well. In 2018, Jharkhand Union Minister Jayant Sinha honored and garlanded lynching convicts at his own house. BJP ministers Chaudhary Lal Singh and Chandra Prakash Ganga also spoke in support of Kathua rapists who abducted, drugged, raped, tortured and killed an 8-year-old in Kashmir. Maktoob Media was the first media outlet to report and bring limelight to Asif's lynching in May. Later, our reporter Mir Faisal visited Asif's family who were living under fear and extreme trauma. Muhammad Hanif, Asif's uncle, told Maktoob that After the Mahapanchayat, a mob had gathered around the village, hurling abuses and raising slogans like, "Mulle, we will kill you." They were also flaunting their swords, and the whole thing was a scene of extreme terror to the Muslim community in that village. Since BJP came to power, mob lynchings have become so common. And why wouldn't they, when these killers are not just supported by the system, but also celebrated and ensured that they will rise to power and fame? You know, growing up, I was taught that India is all about valuing its rich and varied heritage, that there is unity in diversity, and that all the faiths lived harmoniously in India. Now, years later, I'm exposed to a different reality, that as a Muslim in India, I might not have a future, that I can get killed, raped, burned alive on camera just because of my identity, and that my parents, my family, just like Asif Khan's today, despite being exposed to hate and violent messages all around them, despite having to mourn and tackle trauma while the murder is being celebrated, will still probably say, "We are quiet, because if we talk, matters will only worsen. It will become a bigger Hindu and Muslim issue. Then innocents will lose their lives on all sides. How is that fair?" That is why we are not saying anything at all.